Now let us take some problems on simple band break. Here I am marking the first question. Let's read what is given here. A band break acts on 3/4 circumference of drum, 500 mm diameter, which is keyed to a shaft. The band break provides a breaking torque of 225 Nm. Full stop. One end of the band is attached to a fulcrum pin of lever and the other end to a pin 120 mm from fulcrum pin. If the effort applied at 550 mm from the end of the fulcrum and mu is 0.3, find the effort when the drum rotates anti-clockwise and then when the drum rotates clockwise. So this is the question which we have in front of us. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. The type of break, here it is simple band break. It is given, a band break acts on 3/4 circumference of drum. 3/4 circumference of drum means the band break is in contact with the break drum for 3/4 of the circumference. Means if we write it in the form of degree, it would be 3/4 of 360 degree, that becomes 270 degree. So this is the other way of saying that the angle of wrap, that is the angle of contact between the bend and the break drum, that is 270 degree. So therefore theta will be equal to, I'll convert it into radian by multiplying it by pi and divided it by 180. So theta comes out to be 4.7 radians. Next, circumference of drum, 500 mm diameter. The diameter of the drum is 500 mm. So therefore radius will be 250 mm or 0.25 meter. Next, the band break provides a breaking torque of 225 Newton meter, T suffix B, 225 Newton meter. Next, they are saying that one end of the band is attached to a fulcrum pin. So I'll draw the diagram. Here they are saying that one end of the band is attached to a fulcrum pin of the lever. So here we have a lever and over that there is a fulcrum pin. So one end of the band is attached to the fulcrum pin. Next, and the other end of the pin to a pin 120 mm from fulcrum pin. So 120 mm from the fulcrum pin we are attaching the other end of the bend. Next, if the effort applied at 550 mm from the end of the fulcrum, it means effort is applied at 550 mm from the fulcrum. Next, mu is 0.3, that is coefficient of friction. Find the effort when drum rotates anti-clockwise and in clockwise direction. So I have to find out how much is the value of effort applied when the drum is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, and second when it is rotating in clockwise direction. This is theta, angle of contact. Now, breaking torque is given in the problem. So I'll start the solution with that. Solution. I'll take the first case, that is for anti-clockwise rotation. I'll say that since breaking torque T suffix B is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius of break drum. I'll call this as equation number one. Now, when the drum will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction, that is the first case of anti-clockwise rotation. So here I'll draw the diagram of the brake drum. When the brake drum will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then here we are having the fulcrum. I'll say that this is point O and this is point A. So from point O, the band will be pulled. So this becomes tension in tight side, and it will be delivered to point A. So that becomes tension in slack side. So these are the directions of belt tensions. Now, I'll say that since belt tension ratio, it is given by T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta, because this is the belt tension ratio formula. Therefore, T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu, it is given as 0.3. Theta we have converted into radian, that is 4.7. So finally I will get the relation of T1, T2. That is, T1 is equal to 4.11 times of T2. I'll call this as my second equation. Now after getting the belt tension ratio, I would be taking the moment of all forces about the fulcrum, which is point O. I'll take the moment of all forces at point O. So here I'll say that therefore taking moments of all forces about point O is equal to 0, that is for the equilibrium condition. So therefore summation of moment about O is equal to 0, where clockwise moments are positive and anti-clockwise moments are negative. So therefore if I see in the diagram, P into 550, that is anti-clockwise, so negative. Then as we can see here, when it is anti-clockwise rotation, then tension in tight side is passing through the fulcrum, and when tension in tight side will be passing through the fulcrum, its moment will be 0 because it is passing through the point about which we want to take the moment. So T1 will be 0, the moment of T1 will be 0. For T2, it comes in anti-clockwise direction, so it will be minus T2 into the distance between O and A, it is 120 mm. So it is minus T2 into 120 is equal to 0. Therefore, here I will be getting the relation of P and T2. I'll say that therefore P will be equal to this minus T2 into 120. When this shifts onto the other side, it becomes plus, and here there is minus sign. So this will be minus T2 into 120 divided by 550. I'll keep this as my third equation. Now, since braking torque is given in the problem, I'll say that from equation 1, braking torque value, it is given in the question, 225 Newton meter is equal to braking torque is T1 minus T2 into R. So therefore instead of t1, I will write it as 4.11 times of t2 minus t2 into r. R is 0.25. From this, I will get t2 as 289.38 newton. Next, I'll put this value of t2 in equation number, in equation 2, so I will get the value of t1. So I'll say that put t2 in equation 2, therefore t1 is equal to, this comes out to be 118.38 newton. That is, I have multiplied 289.38 with 4.11 because that was the relation. Now after getting t1, t2, I will say that put value of t2 in equation number 3 to get the answer of p. So I'll say that put t2 is equal to 289.38 newton in equation 3. So therefore p is equal to minus 289.38 into 120 divided by 550. So my value of effort comes out to be, it is minus 63.13 newton. That's my first answer. So for anti-clockwise rotation, we are getting the value of effort. Now I'll consider clockwise rotation. For clockwise rotation, I'll draw the diagram of the drum again. Now when the drum will rotate in clockwise direction, at that time the belt will be pulled from point A, so this becomes tension in tight side, and it will be delivered to point O, so this becomes tension in slack side. So therefore here I'll say that taking moments about point O is equal to 0. Therefore, summation of moments about O is equal to 0, where clockwise moments are positive and anticlockwise moments are negative. So therefore, here I am getting P into 550 as negative because it is anticlockwise. So minus P into 550. Then we want to take moment about point O, and T2 is passing through O, so its moment will be 0. So here I have only T1 into 120, which is plus because it is clockwise, is equal to 0. So therefore P is equal to T1 into 120 divided by 550. So it's equal to the value of T1, that was 1189.38 into 120 divided by 550. So the value of effort that comes out to be 259.50 newton. That is the second answer. So if we look into the question, they were telling to calculate the effort required for anticlockwise and clockwise rotation. We have calculated both the values, and with this we complete the problem.